Let's sing together, okay? Okay, sing people.
People come together, strangers, neighbors, our blood is one. Children of generations, of every nation, of kingdom. So don't let your heart be a trouble. Hold your head up high, don't fear no evil. Fix your eyes on this one truth. God is madly in love with you. So take courage, hold on, be strong. Remember where your help comes from. Say,
swing wide.
Swing wide, all you heavens, let the praise.
All right, saints, are you ready? Okay, if you are wanting to get hype, next two songs, the most hype, ready? Upstairs, I don't see you jumping, so I got one more song to jump.
Impossible. Yes, indeed, Lord. With you, nothing is impossible, and in you, we can find our strength. Some of you may be feeling that you may be facing any pain, struggles, or suffering, but and you wonder whether God is really there for you, whether He is really watching. But as long as we look to the cross and we see all the things that He's done for us, His precious sacrifice, that He sent His only Son, Jesus, to die for us. And then we know that our God is so good, our God is so kind, our God is so gracious to us. So, as we sing the next song, I just want to remind all of us that no matter what you're going through, God is there for you, God is watching, God is fighting your battles with you. So, as we sing the next song, let it be a prayer unto God. Let it be a prayer of surrender, a prayer of trust in Him.
Thank you.
Now y'all can take a seat.
Hi guys, I'm Charmaine, and today I'll be sharing with you my testimony. So I've been born into a Christian family, but my grandparents are not Christians. They are very committed Buddhists. In the past, my parents have tried to ask them to come to church, but they have always been constantly rejected. Last year, my ama discovered that she had stage 4 breast cancer. It was most alarming to me because I never knew when the last day I would see her would be. And if she wasn't safe, I would not be able to see her in heaven. I've always been someone who is very shy to ask others to come to church. But on one service, my pastor preached about not just having the courage and faith to step out, but to also to have faith in him and invite my grandparents to church. Since then, I've set aside time for God in the midst of my studies and CCA. Every night I would have a mini worship session on my bed and I would pray fervently. After 2 weeks, I mustered the courage and called up my ama to ask her if she wanted to come to church. God was good and she agreed to come to service. Although she was hesitant before coming, in the end, she came for the service and thank God she said the sinner's prayer and decided to believe in Christ. The following Tuesday, her medical test results came out. Previously, she really did not want to go for operation, neither did she want to go for chemotherapy. By God's grace, the doctor said that her tissues were soft and she did not have to go for surgery. Praise the God. Praise Lord. Through this, I have learned that God listens to our prayers and that He never, ever belittles our hurt and sufferings. Even in our darkest times, He will be there to guide us every step of the way. He will never leave us nor forsake us. For some of us here, we may be coming all smiley and happy, but deep inside us, we might know that we are guessing out, we're just really tired and exhausted. In Matthew 11:28, it says, "Come to me, all of you who are weary and tired, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." God's love is extravagant. Though we are incomplete, He loves us completely. Though we are imperfect, He loves us imperfectly. He loves every single one of us, even those who are flawed, rejected, awkward, sorrowful, or broken. As we go into the next song, I just hope that you will let the lyrics minister to you and just open up your hearts tonight.
Rising around me, Jesus.
God's love is extravagant. And it's for me, and it's for you. The Bible says that for God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, so that whoever believes in Him will not perish but have eternal life. I'm sure many of you have heard this verse before, whether you are Christian or not. What's so special about this verse is that God loved the world first. Before any of us could believe in Him, He loved us. Whether we were going to believe in Him or not, He loved us. He loved you. And tonight, this is the God that we are worshiping, the God that we want to share with all of you. A God that created you and loved you before you could even respond to Him. And I pray that no matter where you come from, what you are going through, or what you believe in, that tonight you will receive God's extravagant love for you. Can I invite us to stand as we sing the next song? Thank you. Will you pray with me? Thank you, Lord, that really you love us so much that you gave your Son to die for us, such that even in this broken world, we have hope. That there is a future in you and with you. That you have overcome all our struggles and our pains. That we can be fearless.
Your very body began.
hear me?
You hear me when I call. You are my morning song. Though darkness fills the night, it cannot hide the light. Whom shall I fear? You crush the enemy underneath my feet. You are my sword and shield. Though troubles linger still, whom shall I fear? I know who goes before me. I know who stays behind. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, he is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side.
Wow. Good evening. Good evening. I got lost. What school is this? Okay, thank you very much. I'm not going to give you any money for that. All right? Okay, please sit down, sit down, sit down. This is amazing. I want you to put your hands together for the crew and the band and everyone who has put in all the effort to do this tonight. Okay? My name is Leon, okay? Just give you a quick background. I think there are some people out here who know me, all right? Because I met a few familiar faces. I'm a youth pastor from St. Paul's Church, which is just down the road at Upper Serangoon. And it is an honor and a privilege to be here to share with you a message of hope. And I've only have 20 minutes, but this is most likely going to be the most important 20 minutes that some of you all are going to have to make a decision that will be life-altering. Now, it is not about me, it's not about the band, it's about Jesus. That's the reason we're here. And so I'm going to share a very short story that's taken from the Gospel of Mark. Mark chapter 1 is in the New Testament. For those of you all who have never seen or read through a Bible, there are two parts of the Bible. There's the Old Testament, there's the New Testament. And so the book of Mark, in chapter 1, verse 40 to 45, there's a little story in there about Jesus encountering a leper. All right? And in that story, Jesus was walking around and ministering to people that he saw. And in those days in the Bible, if a leper was in the town or if he was walking around, from a distance, he has to shout out to the people. If he's coming, for example, down Orchard Road, if he's going down Orchard Road, all right, he can't go into crowds. He has to shout himself out, unclean, unclean, unclean. And people will know immediately that he is a leper. And if you know about leprosy, parts of your body literally fall off. And so they were people who were despised, people who were isolated, people who were put out of the society and the community. They had to stay in the desert, in desolate areas. And so the story goes like this. Jesus is walking through this place. A leper sees him. A leper calls out to him, "Lord, Lord, if you're willing, please, help me." Jesus, filled with compassion, looked at the leper and said, "Yes, I am willing. I'll be healed." And the leper's skin was restored. And then Jesus told him straight. Jesus told him, "Do not tell anybody of this." Kind of strange, lah, okay? Because there were many people moving around with Jesus and they saw this miracle. But Jesus told this leper, "Don't tell anyone of what I've done to you. What I want you to do is I want you to go back to the temple, present yourself to the priest, the high priest there, and offer an offering to God according to the law of Moses," because that was the way they lived their lives and how they celebrated and worshiped God. But instead, the leper went around telling people what happened of this miracle. And so, Jesus charged him not to, but he went around and he told everybody of what happened. And people then knew who he was. They knew exactly who this guy was. He was formerly a leper. And probably when they saw him, they went, "Oh, piang oi, you're so different now." I'm Singaporean, by the way. I'm not Ang Mo, okay? If you know Joseph Schooling, you all know Joseph Schooling?
You heard of him? You heard of him, right? He's Eurasian, right? Yeah, so I'm Eurasian, okay? Yeah, but he's better looking, lah. Yeah, okay, anyway. Thank you for that compliment. I'll let my wife know. Just to remind her, lah, okay? Okay, anyway, back to the story. All right, back to the story. So Jesus told him not to tell, but he went on telling everybody about what happened. And you know what happened after that? Unfortunately, Jesus had to go into isolation. Jesus had to go and hide. The Bible says very clearly in verse 45 that Jesus could no longer move around and minister to people openly because he was now identifiable. So he had to go into hiding, into desolate places, into quiet places and hide. It's so strange. A reversal took place. A divine exchange took place between Jesus and that leper. I'm speaking to those of y'all right here, right now, who are not Christians. Okay? I'm speaking to this first group of people who maybe your friend brought you here and you had no idea what you were coming here for. But you came. So I want to speak to those people right now, that group of people. A divine exchange took place between Jesus and this leper. Now this leper was in full view of everybody, showing off himself to everybody suddenly. But Jesus had to take the backstage now. This leper was once isolated. He was alone. He was rejected by society. He had low, super low self-esteem. He was no one to be reckoned with. He was a nobody. He was someone who the community would despise to the core. Once upon a time, more than 20 years ago, I was like a leper. This is the real me. I was despised. I was rejected. I told God I don't need you. I am God. As far as I was concerned, I was God. I had super low self-esteem. I used to be criticized. I used to be put down by people. So what do? Get stupid. Go to the tattoo studio, sit down there. Get high on drugs. And let the tattooists tattoo my body all over. I'm not here to promote myself. I'm not here to promote about my tattoos. I'm here to promote Jesus, that's all. 19 years ago, a supernatural thing happened to me. My mom was a Christian. I used to take my mom's Bible, her Bible, no. The most treasured possession of a Christian. I threw it at her. I said, you can take your beep, 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 God, and shove it up your beep, 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 beep. That's what I used to do. Yeah, really, really. Wooden crosses in my mom's home. I'll take it, I'll crack it, I'll throw. I say, you can take your God and go to hell. Because as far as I'm concerned, I was God. I didn't need God. But Jesus, in his wonderful, unconditional love, he didn't wait for me to clean up my act. He didn't wait to say, oh, Leon, let me see, let me look down at you right now, wait for you to get all clean and proper and prim and everything, and then I'll come down and I'll save you. He didn't do that. I encountered him in the hospital when my second child, my son, was born with an illness. He was miraculously healed. Doctors have no clue who in the world saved this little baby at 28 days old. But in that hospital, I heard the voice of God. I cannot deny it. You know why? I know it's God. Because he called me by my name. Go and ask any Christian ask them to show you in the Bible, are there men of the Bible who God called them by name? Yeah, there are three people I can tell you right now. First person was Moses. Second person was a little boy named Samuel. The third person, the most powerful encounter recorded in the New Testament, was a man by the name of Saul. Jesus knows you by your name. And so I heard the voice of God, Leon, Leon, after all that you have done, I still love you. Wow. I was dead in the hospital and I was not high on drugs. Okay? Disclaimer, I was not high on drugs. I recognize at that point, there was this divine presence in the hospital ward. My wife was there. She looked at me because I went, do you hear that? Do you hear that? And she said, hear what? I said, I heard a voice. And she said, no, she didn't hear anything. She thought I was mad. But twice in the hospital, that voice came to me. And I felt so, so guilty and remorseful that morning, I remember. Tears started rolling down my eyes. It was such an embarrassing moment because here I am all hunky-dory and all fit and looking cool and everything. You're crying. Cannot. You know, must cover face. I walked away. I went to the lobby of the hospital. The first person that came to my mind was my mom. I called my mother. I told my mom what I was experiencing. And like all mothers, this is what her reply. You see, like, you take drugs some more. Now hearing voices. I said, no, mom, I'm perfectly sober. And then I suddenly heard weeping, crying. Mom? The love of God will just break you down. So there was my mom crying on the phone. And I said, mom, why are you crying? She said, son, I've been praying for you close to 18 years for the day that God will reach out and touch you and turn you around. Wow, my knees went weak. We both started crying on the phone. For a good few minutes, we were on the phone. This big, burly guy crying on the phone was crazy. No one has ever made me cry. But the day when I heard the voice of God, and I know it was Jesus Christ, because I asked my mom the stupidest question. I said, mom, who is this God you pray to? And she said, the God of the Bible. The same Bible you threw at me. That's Jesus. He's not looking for perfection, because none of us can be perfect. He's looking out at you. No one can tell you, oh, I found God. No. You never find God. God finds you. I want you to bow your heads now. Everyone, I want you to just close your eyes. I don't want anybody to open their eyes. I want you to close your eyes. Don't look at me. Even though your friend said I'm good looking. Don't look at me. Close your eyes. Please. It's just you. Don't look to your friend. Don't look to your left. Don't look to your right. It's just you. I'm going to speak to you. I want you to just listen to what I have to say. I'm talking to the group of people here right now who have never, never, never experienced the love of Jesus. Because why? Because somebody said, you're not good enough. This loud voice in the background, you're never good enough. You're hopeless. You can never make it in life. You won't do well. You're getting all the negativity coming to you. Right now, open your heart. Don't use your mind. At this moment, you don't use your mind. Just open your heart. If you're feeling right now, your heart, there's some kind of something happening, butterflies or something. and you've never experienced the love of Jesus, you didn't expect to come to a concert where they talk about God, I'm just going to say a little prayer right now and just ask Jesus right now through the Holy Spirit to minister to you. Every head bowed, every eyes closed. Holy Spirit, I ask you right now, move among everybody here. Move among those, Lord, who do not know you. Or maybe, Lord, they have been so put down by their friends and their family members. They've maybe been talked down. They've been oppressed. They've been said they're never good enough. But Lord Jesus, in your eyes, we are your perfect creation. Because you said it is good. And so I'm talking to the people, the first wave of people. You have never experienced the love of Jesus. This is just between you and God right now. What I'm going to do is I am going to invite you to raise your right hand. If you feel moved, you're feeling some kind of emotion building up, don't wrestle with it. That is the Holy Spirit ministering to you, massaging your heart and telling you that He loves you unconditionally. You heard the words of the song just now. For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whosoever believes in Him, whoever who believes in Him will not perish but have everlasting life. At a count of three, I'd like you to raise your right hand and just keep it up so that I can see from the stage and I can pray for you. One, two, three. Put it straight up. Do not be shy. Put it straight up. Put your right hand straight up. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Keep it up there. Keep it up there. Just keep your hand up there. I tell you why. Because all of us have individual fingerprints. They're unique. So when you put your hand up, you're like showing God, Lord, it's me. It is me. He can look down. He can see you. He can see your fingerprint and He'll say, ah, yeah, that's the one. That's the one I made. That's my child. That's my son. That's my daughter. Amen. Thank you. Now you put your hand down. I'm going to pray for you. Thank you very much. Lord Jesus, you saw the hands that have gone up. Lord Jesus, you are the one that created us. Lord, you are the one that is mentioned in Psalms 139. Before we were born, before we came into being, we were woven in our mother's womb intricately. And you knew us full well. Lord, I pray for the people who have raised their right hand up. Lord, I pray right now, Holy Spirit, Lord, I pray you pour out your love on them. Allow them to feel your presence right now, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Now I'm going to pray for the second group of people, and this is what's going to happen. The second group of people, maybe you're a Christian, but today, suddenly, this evening, suddenly you just felt, oh God, I got to rededicate my life to you because I've been doing stuff that's not pleasing to you. If that is you, oh, raise your right hand up, man. Just raise your right hand up. One, two, three. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Father, for those of us who have not been living our lives pleasing unto you, Lord, I pray right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. Father, you forgive them. And Lord, you help them, Lord. Help them to recover. Help them to move on, Lord. Thank you, Father, that they want to rededicate their lives to you. Thank you. You can put your hands down. Thank you. Now I'm going to take a bolder step for the first group of people who put your hand up. If you came here with a friend, maybe your friend brought you here. All right? Or maybe you're alone here by yourself. It's okay. I want to challenge you It's a very, very, it's not a tough challenge. All you need to do for the first group of people is I'd like you to stand up right now. One, two, three. Stand up. Come on, don't be shy. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Now come on down here, right here. Come down right here. Come on down. Come on down. Don't be shy. I should be shy. I'm all alone here. Come on down. The first group of people to raise your hands up, come on down. Come, stand right here. That's right. Stand right here. Face the front. You don't need to look at the people behind. Just stand right here. Come on. Come on. Don't feel shy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. It's not about me. It's all about God, all right? You know, when you come down here, you are not showing off. You are actually taking the challenge to the next level. I'm speaking to you guys. You're taking the challenge to the next level. And hey, smile. Jesus loves you. Hello. Don't let that come. All stand in front of the face like this. Come on. Be happy. Hey, who said Christians cannot have fun, right? Hello. Where are my Christians? Okay. All sleeping. Okay, I'd like to invite the counselors, the prayer partners to come down here. I can't really see you because I'm blinded by this bright light. Yeah. Please come be with them. The second group of people, I haven't forgotten you yet. I like the amen. Louder, la, brother. Thank you. The second group of people, I'd like you to come down too. You come down over here. This side. This group, yeah, shift down. Shift to the right. Shift to your right. Shift, shift, shift. Shift to your right. Second group of people, come down on the left. Over here. Right over here. Those who said, I want to rededicate my life to Jesus. You come down. Come on down. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Remember, none of us should be judging you. Okay? We're not here to judge you. We're here to love you. All right? Whatever fears you may be having, whatever fears that you've been struggling with all your life, hey, Jesus knows. Amen. Okay, move forward a bit. Move forward a bit here. First row, move forward a bit. Yeah. Ushers, if you can help. I'm going to move them up here. Just move forward to the stage. Move forward to the stage. Yeah. Wow. Thank you, Jesus. You want to sing a song, Mr. Worship Leader? I'll leave it to you.
Those that are not in the front can sing along with me. Are you hurting and broken within? Overwhelmed by the weight of your sin? Jesus is calling. Have you come to the end of yourself? Do you thirst for a drink from the well? Jesus is calling. Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was there.
band, just hold on for a minute. Let me just pray for everybody here right now. Lord Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for your presence. Father, we thank you for all the lives that are here right now. Lord, we thank you. Oh, Father, you know each one of them, Lord. Father, we don't want to forget the people who are sitting out there, Lord. Father, you love every single person in this room right now. Let's join in prayer, people. Let's join in prayer, all right? Let's just pray for our friends who are here right now. Those of you all who are seated there, you can pray for your friends right here, right now. Father, we thank you, Lord. We ask, Holy Spirit, this is all yours. This is your concert, Lord. You brought life to us on the cross. When you spread your hands out, Lord Jesus, you were saying, I welcome you in love. And so, Father, we thank you, Lord, for your great love that was shed on the cross. I pray, Lord, right now for everyone here, Lord, that you will bless them. Father, thank you so much, Lord. Today is going to be a new day for many lives. Tonight, Lord, a lot of decisions have been made. Lord, we thank you for the testimony that was shared earlier on. We thank you, Lord, that grandma is good. Thank you, Lord, for the miracle. Thank you for your love. And Father, I pray right now, Lord, that everyone who has come forward this evening, whether it's the first wave, the second wave, I pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus, all decisions made are sealed and signed with the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Leave behind your regrets and mistakes. Come today, there's no reason to wait. Jesus is calling. Bring your sorrows and trade them for joy. From the ashes, a new life is born. Jesus is calling. Oh, come to the altar, the Father's arms are.
Hi everyone, I'm Chris, and I just want to say once again that, you know, for those of you in the front, it's really very brave of you to come forward, and this is what we really want to do for you. For those who are here, you want to respond, you want to be prayed for. Can I have you just raise your hands up? Haven't been prayed for, raise your hands up. My friends who are here in the front, you're a Christian, you know, and you are standing with your friend who has raised their hands. Can I just encourage you? Turn to the person, pray for him or her. If no one is coming to you, don't worry, keep your hands up. We'll send the counselors to come and pray for you, shall we? Just keep your hands up. Just keep your hands up if you want to be prayed for. Okay? Just give us some time. Just give us some time.
Oh, what a Savior. Isn't he wonderful? Christ is risen. Bow down before him, for he is Lord of all. Sing hallelujah. Christ is risen. Oh, what a Savior. Oh, what a Savior. Bow down before him.
can I invite those that have responded and been prayed for to move to your left and exit through the exit so that you can talk to you and minister to you further. So you have been prayed for, can exit through the door. Those of you who haven't been prayed for or have yet to respond, you can come to the front. Just raise your hand, somebody will come along and pray for you.
Are open.
the mountain I could not climb. In desperation, I turned to heaven and spoke your name into the night. Then through the darkness, your loving kindness tore through the shadows of my soul. The work is finished, the end is written. Jesus Christ, my living hope.
Encore is like start the concert again. So, are you ready? Come on, Saints, you can do better than that. I say, are you ready? Okay, just now I was quite disappointing because y'all learned the dance already but you never danced with me. But okay, y'all have a second try. Go. I was lost with a broken heart. You picked me up, now I'm set apart. And from the ash I am born again. Forever safe in the sacred sands. But you are more than my words could say. I follow you over all my days. I fix my eyes following your ways. Forever free. Introduce the band one by one. So without them, there's no concert tonight. So from my left, all the vocalists. First vocalist, Martha. Okay, some J2 rap. Eugene. Okay, then on my right, Joel, but my name is Joel, so we call her Joelle. Now J2 rap, Meng Zhu. And then giving the nice testimony and sing very nice just now, Shami. Okay, here's someone very special. You don't know whether she's a saint or not, but give it up for Chloe. Okay, let's go behind. On the keys, we have Sandra. And on the other keys, and just now she played cello. Her name is like Brett. Give it up for Rai. Okay, she played guitar and she saved all the goals. That's why we are in the finals. Give it up for Gladys! Okay, on the left side, standing on the thing, making him even taller, Andrew! And then this man over here, he looks like he's very old, but actually he's only 42 years old. Give it up for Jerome! Okay, some say he's Superman because his name is Clark Kent. Okay, this year is very special. We have two drummers. You don't need to go to the River Safari because we have our own panda, Kai Kai. And this fastest hands I've ever seen in my life. Give it up for Noah! Okay, there's us here, but there's also people behind. So give it up for David and the sound crew. And then the biggest boss, who is actually in our ears, and then the voice just now, is Chris. Okay, we have like not enough time to thank everybody, so everybody else give a clap. Okay, wait, my MC is Eileen and the boys! Okay. Give yourself a clap! Thank you, you have been great, let's go!
Yeah, you are my freedom, really.
One, two, three, let's go!
Gotta burn on the world in motion. Gotta Salvation is here and He lives in me. Salvation is here. Salvation that died just to set me free. Salvation is here. Salvation is here and He lives in me. Salvation is here.
Okay, do you want to jump? Do you want to jump? Okay, wait, we gotta swap the Noah with the panda.
Thank you.
y'all still go? Can y'all still go? Oh, 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 oh.
Swing wide, all you heavens. for that issue.
Him. Thank you.
family.